Unfortunately for you guys, I was right, and Lyra is the first in the initiative. So unless Irene's picking her nose during the beginning of this fight.
Lyra, please.
I have a very big booger up there.
That's what Harriet's saying in character.
Unfortunately, Christmas also has to die.
Cast Twin Taste on Raijin and Fujin.
Yeah.
Well, Christmas, how the tables have tabled.
Oh my god.
How the turns
shut
table.
Up. Shut up and heal me. I'm not anymore now, am I? I never said that to your face.
You were saying it behind my back.
Everybody was saying behind your back.
Please, Lyra, don't heal me. I'm just fine. I don't need all this blood.
Listen, to be fair, Lyra, people are saying a lot of things behind that fish dump truck.
Shut up, voice of the sky. You're not involved in this.
I kind of am.
Go back to killing us, okay?
There's just two little green sim crystals over Raijin and Fujin.
I'm taunting the dying halfling.
Oh, well, go right ahead then.
I want you to say, I'm a little bandage bitch.
Do a little jig as soon as you get back up.
I'm joking.
Wear a little sailor suit with an oversized lollipop.
Some golden law.
Okay,
I'll cast mass heal like here, I guess, and catch everyone.
Sure. Roll for your heals.
Okay.
This ain't about him.
There he is.
Christmas is just Hat Josuke.
Oh my god! He's fucking Gappy!
Did you call him Hat Josuke?
Yes, it's Hat Josuke. Okay. That's his name.
I mean, that's fair.
Fuck you referencing
him. Don't worry about
part
it.
Eight,
no!
Part 8 is also named Josuke Higashikata.
Yeah, he just ran out of names.
Yeah, he has a little sailor suit.
People call him Gappy because he has a gap too.
Okay, everybody. I guess that only doesn't hit Sona and you. So yeah, everybody else gets 14 back.
Oh, oh thank fucking Christ.
Do I heal Raijin and Fujin as well?
No, you choose who you heal. Also, I think it's, I'm pretty sure you choose all the people in the area.
Also, if it's a zone, you could just put the zone so it's not got them in it.
Hang on.
I don't know how group heal works.
So they can catch me in it, because...
Sure.
Salt, how do I seduce Raijin and Fujin?
We've had this discussion, Waffles. It's not happening. Okay. Pagan holiday to banish the cold.
Oh, Jesus Christ, you're talking about me! What? I was like, what the fuck does that mean?
That's what Rassilon calls it in The End of Time.
So Christmas is gonna move back just a bit to get the fuck out of, harm's way, because that shit fucked him up. Then he's gonna use another mind screw. He's gonna use another mind screw on Raijin. Wait, did that work last time?
Yeah, it did.
Okay, yeah, then yeah.
Yeah, you're thinking another of, Gaius wanted to do his intimidate, and it didn't work because they're not humanoids.
Right, okay. So, yeah, another mind screw.
11, so your save is what, 13, 14?
14, I think. Yeah, 14.
Okay, yeah, so he does fail again. So that is...
3d8.
So... Oh, wait, no, it's, fuck, what's your max spells you cast at? Do you cast at 4? Or 3rd?
4. Or
7.
Level
yeah, 4.
Right, so...
No, I cast 4.
Yeah, so this is 5d8 instead of 3d8.
Woo! Christmas!
I should actually retroactively give you the other 2d8 from the last one, too. I think that one was a half to image? I'll check, don't worry.
Okay.
Mind's like... No, he completely failed that one. Okay.
Oh, nice.
One of my strongest attacks, that's why I saved it.
I mean, fair point.
You can do other things with your spell slots, right? Also, your spell slot's back on short rests.
Yeah. He has been using them.
Yeah, I really just use Eldritch Blast for, like, small shit and save the good shit for, like, boss battle.
The point of your class is that you don't need to save your spell slots for the boss fights.
Well, Eldritch Blast
is
really
good.
Yeah,
you can handle it with it. After your Mind Spikes, Raijin is looking very haggard, but his yokai pride is keeping him strong as he is standing and still beating the drum.
Salt, don't say yokai pride, you'll get Waffles excited.
Shut up!
Oh, I get it.
Holy Waffles Day?
What the fuck is going on?
Look! People keep sending up.
You're the one who took me aside and said, how do I fuck these two dudes, okay?
It started with my fucking cousin stealing my cat litter. Give me a fucking break.
This one started last week.
Oh yeah, true.
I am gonna... Yeah, I got the fucking key points to spare.
I was gonna say, like, go nuts.
I'm guessing the 12 doesn't hit him.
It does not. But the rest of them do.
Get aura'd for 23 health, bitch.
Damn.
Yeah, that is solid. You manage to punch through the gaps in his wind wall again to kind of go at him and avoid getting buffeted by the razor sharp winds in turn.
His blue skin isn't because of his skin pigments, because he's bruised to fuck, because I've punched it so much.
He was blue when you got here.
No, shut up.
That's how far you got beat.
Exactly, I beat him up so hard that he became blue back in time.
Pretty blue.
Okay, somehow Zona fell off the face of this turn order again, so I'm just gonna put it back in.
Nice. Poor Zona.
He just ran off. He left.
He did not. Okay, so Zona's just gonna go first up before you.
That's cool. Also, what constitutes a long rest? Like, how long would that be?
8 hours.
Yeah.
Unless you're an elf.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, elves have elves. Elves are what, like 4 hours uninterrupted meditation or something?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So Zona will load up and fire. Yeah, he is definitely gonna hit with that. Jesus. It's halved though, so it's 8 damage. And that's him. Okay, Harry.
Cool.
Harry Potter.
Harry Potter. So Harriet's gonna fly into a rage.
You were already in a rage.
No, I didn't rage.
Oh, okay, yeah. That was a fight with the goblins, right.
Yeah. So rage, and then she's gonna hit twice with her flail.
Sure.
Ooh.
You don't have reckless attack, right? That's
no, yet.
Yeah.
Oh, actually, first, I will move through Raijin to get advantage, if that's alright.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Okay, yeah, so those
do you want me to reroll back?
Nah.
Cool.
It's not gonna make much of a difference for these guys.
Oh, okay. Alright, so that both hit?
Yep.
Sick. Oh, and the second one's a crit.
Yeah. So that is...
Oh, and both plus 4 to that. And that's Harrod.
Okay. Stinko the clown, what's up?
No, I went already.
Yeah, I'm just gonna fight the shit out of this guy.
Go right ahead.
Oh, it'd be 25 plus my damage from the raid.
Oh, right, yeah, because of your yeah, those both hit.
And then with my bonus action. Okay. So that's the piercing damage, which is magical.
Yeah.
I'm not done.
Yeah, you. No, you killed him.
Oh.
Wait, what?
You're shitting me?
Huh?
Okay, again.
Oh, I told you not to make these guys draw.
Well, you said job. They turned one right and used his once a day thing to obliterate half the party.
Yes, which actually is important because it means that with my bonus action attack, I would have been able to use my unwavering mark attack, so it would do even more damage. An additional 3 damage.
Yeah, so you basically just start biting into him, and with the final one in your kind of bit of savagery against him between you and Harriet, Raijin kind of falls down to a knee as he drops his little drumstick clubs and looks to Fujin and says,
"Well, looks like I'll have to make a temporary exit from this plane for now. I suggest you follow suit, brother."
As he grins to him and throws his head back as he starts to laugh as the thunder around him starts to intensify, and with one big bolt of lightning, he is gone.
Did I action surge last time?
I could not tell you.
I don't know.
Well, if you scroll up, how many attacks did I make last turn?
Just one. No, wait, no, that's con. Never mind.
One attack, and yeah, you just multi-attacked.
Okay, so I only made 2 attacks.
Yep. Yeah, just your regular multi-attack, not action surging. Unless you took the worst play ever and did a single attack and then action surged.
Amazing.
Okay, I'm gonna go up there.
Okay.
Right up there. Action surge, attack this dipshit.
Fucking hell.
Yep.
Take a bite out of crying.
Not taking a bite out of anything with those rolls.
Just chomping at the air.
14 doesn't hit.
Nope. You are smacked away gently by the wind as you attempt to get in on Fujin.
Stop it. Stop.
Stop it, you guys.
Stop it. You're so silly. Stop.
Stop biting me.
Okay. Fujin. So
hopefully he doesn't have any fucking AoE attacks.
No, Raijin was a tough one.
Oh, we're gonna fuck that.
Apparently not very.
I mean, look.
Yeah, we're in
the whole
turn 2 of this combat.
You're gonna curse the session, shut up!
Okay, can I just say, the whole point of this was to have a more long-form dungeon. Not everything was concentrated in the boss fight for the difficulty. Also, Vitrix takes 13. And he gets 2 more attacks. Claws.
Wait, actually, let me double-check something.
You're seeing higher than 22. Nothing.
When I get hit, I'm gonna ward and maneuver.
Okay.
This is
24. Yeah, you don't got anything to that because you used your action, didn't you, motherfucker? 8 damage to you. So, you kind of manage to duck out of the way as he manages to kind of shape the winds into these miniature razor tornadoes that are gonna shoot out across. You manage to kind of matrix dive underneath one of them, but another goes and just rides across the cheek and scratches it in a very big, bloody anime cut. Fujin is going to look to all of you and say,
well, even if I fall here, it's not going to matter. I'll just re-manifest later.
Then we will kill you again.
But you'll have to live with the knowledge that a bunch of mortals, students no less, managed to defeat you. I'm sure that'll go over great with your pals in the Inferno.
Oh no, it's a great honor to finally have humans who can stand against us. It's much more fun that way. Believe me, Lord Yama's going to take an interest in all of you.
Who?
Lord Yama.
Who's this your Lord Yama guy?
He sounds like a One Piece character.
Shut up!
Shut up!
There are Onis in One Piece. Shut up.
It is a Dragon Ball character.
Yeah, Lord Yama. His desk is made of mahogany. Mahogany.
Just like Hunger Games.
Yeah. Yes. I met that guy. I'm sure.
Mahogany.
Myra, do something.
Oh. Okay. I will blast him.
I don't know, can you?
Just a brain.
I'm gonna blast him with Firebolt.
Sure.
Pretty sure I'm like that one. Oh no, wait, I could cast Chaos Bolt at level 3.
Might
as well.
It's up to you.
I could cast Chaos Bolt at level 2. I'm gonna cast Chaos Bolt at level 2.
Sure thing.
I might as well cast it at 3, we're almost done.
Yeah. I think she meant she doesn't have level 3 slots. She has level
2 slots. My fault. Okay, Waffle School, shut up.
No, I don't have a level 3 slot left, but like...
Well, then use it.
Quick, before he starts dooting on his flute.
Fujin doots as he please.
Yeah, that hits.
I get that reference, Waffles.
Thank you. How funny.
Fool, Krishna toots as he pleases.
He's gonna change the weather like in Ghost of Tsushima.
Yeah. Roll damage. Yeah, that hits. Yeah.
Jesus Christ!
Damn!
No one resists the force.
Yeah, you managed to give him a taste of his own medicine and counter against his winds blowing in the other direction in order to get a nice big smackaroony against him, which kind of knocks him off of his standing.
Much like that, bitch.
Christmas!
Hey, it's Christmas, and speaking of force damage and nobody can dodge it, it's that time
resist
again.
Resist it.
Fuck off, whatever, same thing. God damn, fuck me.
Well, they can resist it if you don't hit them, but yeah, the second one hits.
Yeah, of course. Hey, 10 damage, that's not bad.
You managed to snipe him with your ugly little nasty boy beams.
it's a good try, Christmas.
Look, I kind of used up all my, like, Eldritch Blast magic on the goblins outside, so, like, give me a break, alright?
Whatever you say.
You literally have a reservoir of your power in your pocket.
Look, shut up, God, give me a break, alright? Starspawn's a little tired.
Anyways.
I mean, you all know what I'm gonna do.
What are you gonna do?
Betray us. I'm using my 10-foot of reach. I'm gonna attack Vitrix.
Yeah,
and just
this
punch her in the head.
Turns face.
I get it. That's a funny joke.
Yeah.
Oh
wait. Yeah. Do I have some? Oh yeah. No. Vitrix got advantage. So yeah.
Awesome. It doesn't. It only matters on the first one if you get advantage, because the other two weren't going to hit no matter what, but yeah. The first and fourth hit, yeah.
Oh, that's... I hate rolling the least amount on the fucking crit roll. It's the worst.
That's.
I rolled one on both of those damage rolls! Fucking hell!
So that's a really comical... That's a really comical amount for reasons that are about to be clear.
He has one health, doesn't he?
1, 2, 3...
I had a really cool fucking one-liner if I killed him too.
Was it Omaiwa Morshin, dude?
No.
Yeah, so... Guys, as you manage to give him the what for and deck him around as Fujin... As Fujin is knocked down with his flute tumbling from his hands, Zona is going to run up and do a very quick kind of throw the cartridge in the air and then throw the gunblade into it in order to reload. He throws it upwards and then catches it like Dante style and points the barrel down at him. It says, "Shut the fuck up."
Dante flips his guns. He does it in MVC 3.
No, that's how Nero reloads the Blue Rose at the start of...
Yeah, I'm saying the firing part. Anyways,
say something cool, Zona.
Jackpot.
Something cool.
Oh, sorry, that wasn't a fucking redneck accent.
No, wait, he can't do jackpot. Here. He's not next to Beatrix.
No, why are you Virgil?
Because I'm the one. Gun. I'm the other person that has a gun.
Yeah, no, that tracks.
Dante says jackpot in every game, though. That's his thing.
But
no,
yeah, he
says
but the Yahoo cool in one is in DMC 3.
No, it's in DMC 3.
Nerd. Now you've woken us to justice.
Shut the fuck up. I'm trying to think of something for you to say.
Yeah, that's what he says.
Been merged.
Merged, I'm trying to think of one liner.
Merged, I need to think my D&D group is cool. I need to think I'm cool.
As long as just like standing there pointing his gun waiting for him to...
just like thinking...
Hold on a minute, I've almost got it.
It's like XCOM right before you commit to doing an action where everything's just in freeze frame, and there's the big counter that says like 99%.
As his gun is right through Fujin's head.
Gun puns. What's my gun pun?
The camera just focuses on Zona and you just hear the fucking dial up fucking sound.
Oh no, he's crashed.
Just say it's the first thing that pops in your mind, Zona. Don't think too hard about it.
Poo poo pee pee.
Sorry.
What's in his head?
I like this is his.
No, you're fine. You're fine, Scott, you're fine. I'm just thinking like in character. There's just big ass pregnant boss. Like Fujin's waiting! All the heels are waiting!
just kill the boss.
I
see, so if you'd let me kill him, you would have had an awesome one liner to finish off Fujin, but no.
I don't need to.
Kill the bloody boar.
Kick the boar.
Kill the bloody boar.
Oh my god. The only time Maul fight quality better is a piece of cake.
Okay. Yeah, Zona is going to finally aim it in point and say, "How about you go back to hell? There's people on your level down there," and he's going to fire.
That was good.
That doesn't really, like...
No. No, it's fine. It's done. It's done. We're done. It's done.
It took 15 minutes for that, Zona!
Oh, I realized I had haste. I could have attacked an extra time. I could have killed him!
Cuck.
God fucking...
You let the DMPC cuck you, knife.
Oh my god!
I have haste and can attack multiple times per turn. I sleep in a big bed with my wife.
Oh my god.
I'm losing my shit.
I'm gonna have a fucking stroke.
Oh my
god.
So what happens when he gets shot?
Yeah,
Hold on, no, I actually gotta take a water break. I'm actually dying.
So displeased.
Yeah, as he's shot, he skids backwards slightly as his lower body starts to dissipate in the wind, as, the coins around him swirl and kind of skitter with metallic clangs across the ground. Fujin looks up to all of you, and, he just grins with his big, crooked, misshapen Oni teeth, and he says, "Here's to our next battle, humans," as he dissipates.
Why do we keep finding these dipshits that just want to fight us for poorly defined reasons? First it was that Perseus guy, now it's these guys.
Hey, leave Perseus alone, he was cool.
I think this is just how they have fun.
Yeah, this could also just be like their definition of fun.
Okay, well, the problem is solved.
Boring, right?
Yeah, are you happy, Zona? Have we increased your S-Link?
Oh, I mean, yeah, I had tons of fun. He kind of kicks a couple of coins around and says, so, what are we going to do about all this?
That is a good question. And how many coins are there?
Authorities?
Lyra's already, like, putting it into our pockets.
I'm already holding my gun blade and pointing it at you.
All right, chill out. Look, as much as I am a fan of the idea of taking this for personal reasons, because, I mean, who the hell is going to stop us?
Me.
Why do you care?
Yeah, geez.
They obviously stole this money from people.
Yeah.
Got a point.
Got me there. But I mean, how are we going to even find who any of this belongs to? And also, how are we going to carry all of it out?
We put it in a big bag.
I don't think the authorities will return it. I think the authorities will just keep it for themselves and use it to build, like, more aqueducts.
That's what taxes are for, Lyra.
Yeah, they'll just tax this and say this is, like, tax stuff or whatever. Like, they're not going to give it back to the people, are they?
I mean,
they don't.
Building aqueducts and roads is giving it back to the people.
My village hasn't have any roads or any aqueducts, okay? I'm not seeing any of these so-called taxes.
You guys ever get a feeling of deja vu? I feel like we had this conversation with hippo heads.
Christmas, you're reminded of the fact of the auction that Irving reminded you of, and the fact you're gonna need probably a lot more money than you actually have in order to compete with people.
Guys, listen, we're gonna need this money, right? So, like, let's just, like...
For what?
Like Lyra said, for reasons, certain reasons that I'll talk about later, and, like, well, Christmas kind of makes...
Christmas...
Hi.
That sort of vague answer is something that you're able to do when you're in my good graces. You are not.
Oh my god. Okay, look.
Whoa. Why you need the money.
Why are you pissed off with Christmas, Beatrix?
You slept through it, didn't you?
We'll talk about it later, Lyra. But listen, I have to do an auction, right? That auction thing I mentioned earlier. But, and I don't have the change for it.
Get
and
a
I kind of need the change.
I mean,
you came for money!
I think this is
let me just jump into the job cannon and shoot myself in the job town, Beatrix!
I get that reference.
Christmas, I did offer to assist you in that little endeavor.
Well, yeah, but I still need my own money for, like, other personal business. Like, you think these bandages come cheap?
Yes. They're bandages. What kind of bandages are you buying? You buying, like, fucking linen, cloth, expensive, jingy silk bandages, Christmas?
Well, no, it's a lot. I have to change them out, like, every, like, 12 hours or else I get stinky.
How much pus?
You know, you say that, but I've never seen you change your bandages, Christmas.
Yeah, because I do it in private. Sure. I'm not going to get naked in front of you and just change my bandages. You know, I like, take a shower, then I put on bandages. Then, like, during, like, the midday, I take another shower.
Doesn't count as taking a shower, Christmas.
No, I take actual showers, Lyra! What are you talking about, you fucking fish bitch?
Wow, that's a microaggression, I'm not gonna stand
for it. Okay,
do not get to say that.
Zona's just looking between you guys as you argue, like, if you ever seen the first episode of Teen Titans when Cyborg and Boone are yelling at each other, and everybody else is just, like, standing in the corner.
Guys is just gonna side up to Zona and just go, so, still glad you came along?
Oh yeah, totally, but, I do not envy your daily situation.
Look, alright, I'm just gonna take the money, right? And no. I don't care what you... Yes. And then Christmas straight up
I goes to the money pile. I will punt you through the far gate.
All right. Listen.
Gaius puts a hand on Christmas's shoulder and says, Christmas, it's fine.
How is it fine?
No, I mean, it's fine. You don't need the money. You'll be fine.
I kind of do, though.
Christmas. Christmas, look at me. You'll be fine. Okay.
Well, if you do take the money, I'm not going to let you walk out of here with it.
Oh my god. What? Oh my god.
Are you going to be over with a sudden case of, like, extreme charitiness or something?
Jesus Christ.
Money does belong to the people.
Why are the two toughest women
Harriet,
in this party?
We're the people.
Okay, but it's we're money. Not the people that the money was stolen off.
How do you know? I got pickpocketed.
Lyra, my hands haven't dissipated yet. I can hit you from over here.
I remember getting pickpocketed by a goblin yesterday, okay? Distinctly.
I think that's a lie.
No, Lyra, that was me. I'm sorry. I had to pay for a sandwich. I'm broke right now, Lyra. Give me a break.
Make a sandwich.
Broke.
I spent my money on something important, alright?
Spent money on sandwiches.
I need to eat! I can't survive off of, like, magic, alright?
You get free lunch every day.
You know there's a spell that lets you summon food, right?
Have that spell!
That's for druids.
Well, maybe he should be a fucking druid then.
Yeah, cozy on up to that druid girl.
Buy more money.
Anyway, Gaius is gonna start looking for like
being a druid is an easily acquirable skill.
Hey, Sol, how much money is there in here?
I want to say perception, but let me just double check the skills to see if there's anything better. Yeah, perception.
Okay. I'm not exactly aiming for a hard, like, concrete. It's this much gold in total. Oh, come on.
You know that you are in the multiples of thousands in here.
Okay.
It's not all far more than coins, but, yeah. It is more than you can physically carry out of here yourselves.
Yes, debatable. That's what I was sort of thinking.
I mean, the thing is you need something to carry them in that is big enough to carry them all, because this is small, loose items. You can't just have your arms full.
We get a sack.
A sack big enough to carry thousands in gold coins.
Well, multiple sacks is fine too.
Let's use Gaius's rope.
I'm helping guys carry out thousands of thousands.
Did
of
you sacks. Just say let's use Gaius's rope?
Rope.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Gaius just tripped.
Also, no.
Hey,
can
we knock out Zona for a second? And just, like, carry the money in the wall?
Gaius is gonna start looking for either, like, a cart or, like...
Yeah, they must have had some way of...
Multiples of, like, sacks and, like... Or, like, big sheets of cloth, like maybe a tent or something.
If you go to one of the other chambers, they would have like kind of disassembled carts that you could probably put together with a couple of minutes of work.
Sorry, guys, got to be your robe.
Zona could. Oh wait, you've got a broken arm. Harriet, you're strong.
Sorry, I got a little suggestion before you get too underway on this. Instead of carrying all this gold out, why don't we go to the authorities and tell them to come in?
No, it can't be.
Just about to speak up.
Okay, Christmas, you go do that.
Why don't you go do that?
Yeah, you're like vested with like political society. Yeah. I'm just a stinky like drifter dude. They're not gonna try.
Beatrix, you have as much as I don't want to say it. You probably have the most authority out of all of us.
Right.
Zona, because he needs medical attention. I'll keep an eye on Christmas.
Rude, but understandable.
You go to the authorities. I mean, I guess if anyone else wants to go with you, they're free to.
Sure. I'm going to spit a mouthful of Oni blood out onto the floor and head into Helios.
You just had that this entire conversation.
It sizzles as it hits the floor.
Ew.
That woman scared the shit out of me.
You head out into hashtag society.
Once Zona and Beatrix and whoever leaves with them are gone.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry. Well, I said for Zona to go with her because he needs medical attention.
Sorry, I missed that part.
Yeah, he'll
go. Oh, do not pay the pen. Imagine not paying attention to your players as the GM.
I mean, Lyra's the healer, so.
Lyra's out of healing things.
I mean, also
yeah, she's done all the healing she can do.
Also, getting actual medical attention is beneficial.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, once they're gone, Gaius is gonna pull Christmas aside and just go, okay, look, this auction, how much money do you think you actually need?
Probably
all of it.
No,
he spreads his arms really wide.
Okay, well, how much money do you... Well, let's roll that back. How much gold do you have?
Currently, 10.
I see.
600. You need 600 to pass. You got
And how
six.
Much? How much money do you think you're gonna need for the auction?
Well, it's an auction, so it depends on, like, who actually wants it.
Okay. Gaius is gonna reach up to his shoulder where you see there's a little patch of it looks like a little chest. He rips the patch off, like not doing the thing he just does to do the patch where he like unthreads it to manifest it. He like rips the entire patch off and puts in Christmas's hand and says, look, if you unravel this, it'll manifest a coffer worth about 500 gold. I have a sizable amount myself. Between that and my amount, do you think that'll be enough?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
It's awfully generous.
So at this point, so wait, has Beatrix gone at this point?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna say, okay, guys, I need to go take a leak, and I'm gonna run out of the room. Then I'm going to cast disguise self on me to make myself look like Matrix. And I'm going to come back in and say, hello guys, I changed my mind. I think we should keep all of the gold. Now help me back this up.
Roll deception.
Can I get advantage for looking like Matrix?
Can I just say that Gaius knows this is a ruse but doesn't care and just wants to see how long this goes?
Oh yeah, you can see. You have true sight, don't you?
I do have true sight still.
You just see it me.
I just see. Like, I don't even have the full context. Gaius just sees Lyra walk into the room and say that.
The other thing I was gonna say is you would roll, I think, insight against deception like this, and you're a whiz character.
I'm gonna, like, spray Christmas with my magic water bottle when I pass. You know, just to stay in character.
What do you mean, stay in character?
Come on, Zona, help me fill these big sacks full of gold.
This is the dumbest session. We're not even gonna make it a fucking prom.
Asking for help in carrying a heavy thing, that's something the Beatrix would definitely do.
Yep.
Yep.
Why the change of heart?
I am simply, you know, being a good team leader and including everyone.
Also, out of curiosity, how tall is Lyra?
Oh yeah, does it change? Does it?
Disguise self doesn't change your height. It makes an illusion around you, so like
you can't change the body type.
Yeah.
Oh, but no, the illusion.
No, you can seem 1 foot shorter or taller.
Yes, you can seem 1 foot, but like, if someone tries to hand you a pile of gold and hands it to the illusion, it's just gonna fall straight through because your hand isn't actually there.
Listen, if that's the way it worked, the spell would fucking suck, okay?
Well, it's an illusion spell. That's the drawback of disguise self.
You're not supposed to It's also a level 1 spell. You're not supposed to, like, touch stuff. It's purely for, like, infiltration, okay, but, like, yes, not...
Alter self and polymorph is for...
Bring, like, a foot below where my hands are, okay? Is that what you wanted to hear?
Hey,
I don't know how much you thought this goof was actually gonna get you, how far this goof was gonna get you.
Shut up and let me continue this to the bitter end, okay?
No, I am. I'm letting you continue. I'm just saying it's gonna have
yes, Christmas. Results. What do you want, my disgusting little friend?
Could you do me a favor and just like change it to an animal like you usually do? I just want to see it real quick.
I'm afraid I've done that as many times as I can until the next moon rises.
Nope.
It's gonna recharge my magic werewolf powers, you know.
That's not how it works.
It's a once-a-day ability, so that actually is how it works.
Oh, fuck. Well, she doesn't know that!
You're a little bandage bitch. You don't know anything.
Christmas, I think this is fine. This is perfectly in character for something Beatrix would do.
Guys, agrees with me. This is perfectly in character for me.
It's just a shame Lara isn't here. I know she really wanted to take some of this money. She's gonna be really sad she missed out.
Well, we can.
Actually, that's a good. Actually,
I think we should give it all to her.
Did you? You didn't happen to see Lyra when you came back in, did you, Beatrix?
Oh,
you would have just popped her. Ah, I see.
Water Ganassi, you know, it's like she's pissing up. What's the name of the ocean between the island of what's its name and the mainland?
The island of what's its name?
No, this is a character from Beatrix, not the lore.
Helios. What's the name of the sea between Helios and the mainland?
It's Winter's Palm, I think.
The Winter's Palm Sea. Okay, cool. Yeah, she's pissing out the whole of Winter's Palm. In fact, we better get out of here quickly. She's going to flood this place. Guys, can I help with these bags or not? They're not heavy at all. I think we should work together on this.
You know, it's impressive. Somehow, this is still a better lie than anything Christmas has ever said.
Fuck off! Shut up!
Beatrix, you have had the impulse to sneeze for about 5 minutes now.
So what the fuck are we actually doing?
Well, Beatrix is trying to fill the bag with gold, fill a sack with gold.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, as soon as you try and do that, anyone even remotely looking at you can see the coins like passing
it's
through where your
dark,
hands are.
Okay. It's dark.
It is dark.
Okay, but if anybody's, like, actively looking at you...
Well... I don't know, who's actively looking at me?
Everybody!
Everyone.
You have made yourself into the center of attention.
Don't be fucking ridiculous. Zona, help me out here, because my friends are being useless.
Zona went with the real Beatrix.
Although you are my friend, too.
This is great.
Okay, so what is the result of this adventure? What's gonna happen when I show up again with the cops?
I don't know. That's up to the people in the cave.
They just barricade themselves in and we end up with a Waco situation.
Amontillado!
Does Lyra just fill the one bag or is she filling multiple bags?
The cash of Amontillado.
I don't know. How many bags does she have?
I mean, I assume the goblins would have sacks.
Yeah, she's filling, like, goblin sacks with gold.
Okay, as soon as Lyra fills one bag and, like, puts it aside, Gaius makes a rip in, like, the bottom and just sort of lets the coins just fall out back
now,
into the pile where she can't see.
Do that or you'll make me mad, and when I'm mad, I trample things with my big horse.
No, he's doing it so Lyra can't see.
Surely I can hear the coins twinkling all over the ground.
I mean, not if you're shoveling them into the bag, it all sounds the same.
Well, whatever. I'm filling another sack.
This is the worst session.
That's
this is a
great
session. Shut up.
You, between your 2.5, your 2 bags so far, you have 286 gold pieces.
Ah. Oh.
How many of those fall back onto the pile when Gaius rips the hole in the bottom of the bag?
About half. So 143.
Hmm. These are feeling a bit lighter than I thought.
That's just because you're so strong, Beatrix. I mean, we all know you're the strongest here.
I mean, Beatrix.
Hey, I was not here Christmas. I was taking a piss.
Yeah, no, I forgot the biggest piss in the galaxy.
What's a galaxy?
The biggest piss.
Sounds like heresy to me, guys.
Oh no!
You gonna let him get away with that, guys?
No. Time for the paddle. The anti-heresy paddle.
The Yowie paddle?
Christmas.
Yowie's known for their anti-heretical nature.
You fellas settled on what you're doing here?
I mean,
we don't know what we're doing!
These are fucking morons, just...
Hey.
So, you're the one that's trying to Looney Tunes Lyra.
Yeah, she's trying to Looney Tunes the rest of us. It's only fair.
Using Looney Tunes as like a noun here for?
He's putting a hole in the bottom of the bag so that when you pick them up, all the gold pours out.
That's quite funny. So you know.
Yeah, like Looney Tunes.
Okay. So I'm going to keep doing this. Beatrix, please come back in at any appropriately comedic point.
I mean, I asked what's going to happen when I come back with the cops and I was sandbagged by the GM.
Well, because I need to know what everybody's doing.
Okay, I'm filling the bags with gold.
I'm making holes in the bag so the gold falls out.
Christmas is just there. He's just vibing. He doesn't give a shit.
Christmas is looking like the fucking... guy from Happy Fun Friends when he's fucking like melting or whatever.
Oh, Pim.
Yeah.
Well, if this just goes on ad infinitum until they show up, yeah, the guard will approach with Beatrix, really still open chamber. You can see a small platoon of guards who kind of take in them and say,
I'm seeing double here. Four Vitrixes.
Yeah, you also see one of you very poorly in the very strangely clipping as she's taking some of these coins and trying to put them in a hole filled bag.
I'm gonna reach to around where I guess Lyra's collar would be and just pick her up.
Help! It's an imposter, guys! There's a doppelganger in your midst.
Gaius just has his hand over his mouth, trying not to laugh too loudly.
Well, thank you all for your service. We, had heard about some miscellaneous attacks on merchants nearby, but we never expected it to be reported in such an amount.
Yes.
Well, you're all literally very prolific goblins.
You can leave it in my custody, me. Beatrix.
Beatrix
Beatrixius. I don't know what you're called, imposter.
The captain's just going to look between the two of you and say, "We'll take it from here. All of you can return to."
Yeah, don't worry. I will deal with my team's wizard.
Thank you, Captain.
Yes, you should find that wretched wizard. It appears they've summoned a doppelganger.
Yeah, I think Lyra's a traitor to the Empire, so when Lyra Cliffheim shows up, we better kill her instantly.
Well, Lyra's not here right now. She's taking a big piss, and that's not a traitorous thing to do, so I don't know what you're doing.
I don't know. It seems like she's gone AWOL in the middle of a military operation.
Also,
operation's over right now.
As I said before, we will take it from here.
Oh, yeah, no, we're having this discussion as we're all walking out.
Yeah, I've got Lyra over my shoulder.
I'll drop the spell.
Oh my god, it was Lyra all along?
Who could have seen this coming?
Oh, shut up. You guys didn't suspect a thing.
Not at all. I totally couldn't see through your illusion the entire time.
I am befuddled. I am bamboozled.
Honestly, this was more surprising than finding out that Theseus guy was actually Perseus.
He was what?
It's like saying Santa Claudius isn't real either.
Santa Claudius. Is that just like, is the myth goes, it's just Claudius who comes around every year.
Instead of present, he just punches you directly in the face.
I can't believe
he comes down your chimney and assassinates you.
He comes down your chimney and tells you to go fuck yourself and then appears right back up. Yeah, so you guys all return to the academy, I'm assuming?
Mm-hmm. How's Zona holding up?
He is, as you ask around, at the infirmary, but he is luckily made it in an amount of time that he will definitely be able to recover.
Nice.
Will he ever play piano again?
I couldn't before!
Dr. Zayas.
So, with that in mind, if no one has anything in the next 3 days they want to get done, we will go to the day of the reverie period.
Oh, Christmas wants to pick up a suit.
Yeah. Yeah, you can do that as soon as you get right back. You make your way to the textiles shop and haberdashery.
Oh, I'll go as well to find myself a nice dress.
Nah, you're too fat.
Well, fish don't actually put on fat, so that's not possible.
Yeah, they do.
They don't.
How the fuck would tuna be, like, a commercial fish, then?
It's a muscle, isn't it?
No?
Fatty tuna?
Sorry, you broke my brain for a second. Anyways, Right, anyways.
You okay?
I'm sorry, just the stupid took my brain over for a second. Yeah, sorry, Christmas, you enter Maximilian's establishment.
I'm sorry. Give me a second.
Yeah.
I'm choking on water. Excuse me. Hey, Max. Maximilian. Sir, I'm here to pick up my suit.
You can see him come out from kneeling behind a desk with one of those with just like two needles sticking out one of his lips as he puts both of them in a little pincushion on his desk. He says, "Ah, yes, my young apprentice in the art of astatisticianism. And, who is this?"
Hey, this is, Lyra. She's, a friend? Question mark? She's, actually looking
for Christmas.
I must agree with her. Uncertainty does not bode well for your personal image.
It's a joke. She's a friend. I just like to rib her sometimes. She's actually looking for a dress too.
Yes.
Two? I didn't know Christmas was getting addressed.
Two dresses, please.
Well, first let me just make sure that the order for the young man here is to his liking, and then I'll get right along with you. If you'll follow me, young master.
Yes, of course. Lyra would just stay put and don't do anything weird.
When do I do stuff that's weird?
Don't make me answer that.
Everybody in the entirety of the Apollon Empire stares in your direction, even if they don't know why.
Yeah, it's like Mecca. Everyone's just pointing in the one direction.
They have an app for it. You are brought into the back. You said a pinkish suit, right?
Yeah, pink.
Crazy, right?
No, yeah, pink.
So, You are presented on a mannequin, halfling sized, for the record. He knows what he's working with here. A suit that has this very vibrant pink, but as you kind of get closer to it, you can see it has a not rhinestone quality, but there's kind of a almost a glisten to the weave and to the fabric that as you kind of move forward and back, the light shines off it differently. There's a very lovely white and purplish corsage that is coming up off of it, and it's got these ever so delightful little fingerless gloves on the on the edge, and two very nice little dress shoes, black.
Oh my goodness, this is perfect!
One final feature that I am sure you'll be a fan of. He brings you over to a full-length mirror and kind of gestures you to put your hand over your eyes.
Okay, yeah. And then Christmas covers his whole eyes.
Where'd he go?
Hey, Maximilian, where'd you go? It's so dark!
So he puts something on top of your head and then slowly puts your hands down. You can see a squished flat little hat on top of your head that just looks like nothing. And before your confusion can kind of register, he takes it up and flicks it as it poofs upwards in a lovely little sparkly magical display and puts it back atop your head.
Oh, that's so cool! That is so cool!
Well, this is a gibbous, typically worn to things such as operas, but I figure if you're to address to impress, well, formality is the name of the game.
Oh, it's perfect! Oh my goodness, I feel like a fancy boy now!
Ah, well, that's where you're wrong, young man. The fanciness was inside you all along.
And, like, you can, like, see Christmas's eyes sparkle with, like, boyhood wonderment. Oh, wow! I was always fancy!
You see, my work is not the glistening sun in the sky to give life down to the world below. No, it is a light that is meant to shine on the prism within everyone to make sure that that inner beauty comes outwards in a wondrous prism, in a rainbow of light, so that all may bask in the true selves just beneath the skin. He's clasped his hands together with like that pacha face right now.
Yeah. Just I don't know how to thank you enough for this. This is the first time I've ever had.
Oh please, you already paid me monetarily, and having good work done is reward enough.
Man, I'm gonna come back. I've never had like clothes like this. It's so beautiful.
Please don't.
Shut up. This is my NPC. Get your own.
Sorry.
Well, if you wish for further lessons within the art of beauty and aestheticianism, by all means, the door is always open for apprenticeship. But I will warn you, it is not easy. There'll be many nights left sleepless, your eyes dry with how many tears you've cried out of them over your work, painstakingly had to be perfected. But if you give in to it as much as I have, it will all be worth it.
Thank you. And he gives him like a really quick hug and leaves out with like a giddy gait.
Yeah, he gives you one of those little clear suit and hangers to bring it out in so it keeps nice and pressed.
All right, Lyra, you want to get your
Lyra, you see Christmas has been like crying. The camera just pans over to this fish trailer trash.
That is a fucking camera set.
Hello.
Hey.
Why are you humming like that?
Maximilian takes a look over on you, Lyra, and says, Well, I can't shape clay that doesn't want to be put into something better. How much are you dedicated to this?
Jesus Christ!
Clay?
It is a metaphor.
It's a metaphor for how you look lumpy.
Yeah, that's my joke too. Thank you, Beatrix, in my head that constantly haunts me.
He snaps his fingers, trying to get you back to reality.
What?
Lyra got so into her Beatrix fucking disguise that she accidentally created a Beatrix Tolpa.
It's like Fight Club.
Beatrix is my fucking Tyler, what's his name?
Tyler Durden. Lyra Durden.
Tyler, what? Man, imagine
to form the academy.
Imagine Fight Club, but instead of Tyler Durden, it was Tyler One. That'd be great.
Hey, we need to stop the goose and actually do things the session.
Fuck,
guy.
You're right.
Okay, look, listen. I just want to look nice for prom. Okay, I've never been to like anything like this before. My town had like one meeting hall, and the only things that happened there were like the monthly salmon count, which stunk. Mm.
Small town wanting to impress as you make it to the big city. You need to make an impression.
Right. Sound like a dickhead.
No. I'm just running it through my head. He's like pulling out little swatches of colors and like comparing them one to you. 200 gold.
200. How much was Christmas's?
250, wasn't it?
Yeah.
How much? I don't know how much gold we've actually received.
Nothing! Thanks to Beatrix!
Keep track of it then, you dipshit.
How much did you give us for gold? Does anyone remember?
We didn't get anything.
No, yes. But like in total. Because I haven't. Wait.
We started with 500 gold, right?
Yeah.
Okay, then we've gotten around at least 241 gold, because I have 741 gold.
Okay, cool. I have enough money for this.
Alright. Now, I suppose this is a bit of a personal question. Don't take it in any such way. Do you want me to incorporate heritage into this, or do you want me to go out in bold new directions for you?
No, it's okay. You can make it look watery. That was what I was going to ask for anyway.
Well,
that's not what I meant. I'm just going to make it smell like fish.
I've got a couple jars of garum out the back that I'll dip all the fabric into first.
Well, considering how close the clock is going to be running to this event, we're going to need to have some intensive hours of work if you don't mind staying in the back for this.
Sure.
Can we have a scene of just like Maximilian and Christmas, like Lyris tries on new dress and they're like, no, no, no. Tries on another dress, no, no, no.
Christmas wants to stay for all of it. Yeah, you are treated to an early 2000s pre-teenage girl montage of dress trying on, attempting to get her manners in charge for this prom, and comically failing therein. As Maximilian has brief bouts of despair, but Christmas, you manage to push him through it with both your faith and charisma and wide-eyed enthusiasm of a aesthetician not yet broken by the market at large.
Look, the guy's got four arms, okay? The dancing can't go wrong.
Speaking of... How's Gaius preparing for the prom?
Oh, he just... slap some water.
See,
on
I feel bad because I, like, a couple sessions ago, I, like, just asked Salt, like, privately and did my organization off screen.
Yeah.
Well, I forgot, see, and I didn't want to just turn up in my mage uniform, so.
Like Squidward. So, by the end, like, grueling 6 hours of all of this working. You have never seen anybody work this fast with textiles. By the end of it, Lyra, you are standing in the full-length mirror with this very nice shimmering dress that's got a... It kind of is bell-shaped with the little... what's the word? It's kind of ruffled at the bottom in this nice little on-color, off-color pattern to mimic ocean waves with these very lovely when you kind of when you move the arms, there's a little bit of a thin glittery fabric that kind of has this other wave pattern in it that also iridescently shimmers the same way as Christmas's, kind of in under the armpits and going across. And you also have a complimentary little seashell, little hair clip given to you by him to complete the look.
Wow, thanks.
One more thing. He presses down on the hair clip as it's on your head, and it opens up, and there is just this little, almost like an LED display of a waterfall going down your hair as it changes into a changes into kind of a shorter cut instantly.
That's cool as shit.
That's so cool.
Like I said, I strive to be the best in my field, and I have not been bested since.
Did you go to school for this or something?
You all learn on the battlefield in your martial academy. I learn in the battlefield of dealing with horrid, horrid drab fashion.
Jesus Christ!
You mean dealing with Karens?
The point is, many have not survived the things I've witnessed, but I've come out only stronger for it. You are not sure if he's speaking in metaphor right now.
Yeah, are you saying people, like, regularly die in the fashion industry?
Well, what do you know? Our time is up.
You can't just leave it like that.
No, it's fine, Lyra. It's fine, it's fine.
He puts the cutthroat in cutthroat business.
Shushu, out with you. I need to clean it, close up shop for the night.
Okay, well, thank you again, Maximilian.
Yeah, thanks for your help.
By all means, do return. And he does the lazy Emmett Salk wave and heads back inside.
Oh, do you think I should have got something that matched Gaius's?
I didn't really talk to Beatrix, so...
Imagine your date is gay, so...
Thanks? The fuck?
Wait, have you even gone to, whatever that psycho's name is and declined him?
Yeah.
Don't worry about it.
Yeah, you need to look good while you're doing it.
Because I didn't want to, like, confront him because he scares me.
Yeah, he's gonna shoot up the prom, for sure.
Why the whole prom?
Because he's a fucking psycho.
Collateral damage.
All the other kids with the pumped up sandals.
Fuck you, I was gonna succeed.
I don't know why he thought that shooting a bird in front of Lyra would be like a good come on.
Yeah.
It's fucking psycho. Right, so who else has things they need to do before the prom?
Well, Harriet will retrieve the dress from storage that once belonged to her mother.
Aww.
Take a moment then to describe said dress, sir.
It is a pale green dress with gold trimmings.
Aww.
In almost like leaf patterns. Or viney leaf patterns. Fucking leaf.
Yeah.
I can't believe Harriet was a fucking Canadian all along.
Luckily, storage has managed to keep this thing from too much wear and tear. There is slight fray at the very bottom of the dress, but nothing so noticeable as to affect your night.
Okay. Would Harriet be able to try a hand just to, like, kind of stitch that up?
Let's see what skill that would be. I know there's, like, stitcher's tools or whatever, but...
Yeah.
I guess it would just be regular dexterity. If you have medicine, I guess maybe that would work, because that also involves stitching.
Let me check. I don't think I have proficiency in either of those skills. Yeah, I don't know. Which one would you think?
Probably just dexterity.
Flat dex, alright. 18, fuck.
Yeah, you managed to repair it, and there is basically no difference between it and the last time you saw it worn by Yamada.
She never saw it.
Oh, well.
Her mother died during childbirth.
In Ooh. Your mind's eye, it's exactly how you pictured it.
I mean,
it,
there might be, like, portraits or something.
That too.
Yeah, maybe.
Oh, wait, no, you're, like, poor. Never mind, you didn't get portraits.
No.
You don't
Well, not exceedingly poor, but certainly not.
No, but I mean, you didn't have the money for, like, no. Hey, let's get a professional painter and sit down for a day we could be working.
She's not Lyra Trailer Trash Poor.
Yeah, she's low middle class.
Yeah, Lyra has siblings who wear those little barrels as like
barrels with the shoulder strap.
I thought you were just going to say Lyra's a fucking redneck. I suppose blue neck would be more appropriate.
Whoa, that sounds like a racial slur.
fucking say blue neck.
That's
your neck breather.
You can't say the B word, okay?
Blue?
Breathe.
Hey, watch it.
I guess neck breather would be like a fish people slur, wouldn't it?
Mouth breather, but... Oh, yeah, neck breather would be a slur for fish people.
Oh, yeah, a slur to use against my people.
Okay, Harriet, anything else on the agenda?
Nope.
Okay. Enter the Beatrix. What's up?
You know what I'm planning to do. Do you want me to do it now, or do you want it to be a surprise?
Oh. You may as well do it now.
Okay.
Oh, you're gonna cut Christmas, like, right in front of him with a big, strong Amazonian woman.
I don't think she's an Amazonian. Is she?
Only to Christmas.
Well, I mean, she could turn into, like, a bear, so that's close enough to Amazonian.
Nah, she's small.
But yeah, but what about when she wild shapes?
Still small.
Okay.
Yeah. What are we talking about?
God, how do you pronounce
the only druid you know on campus?
Are you seriously gonna ditch Christmas? That's so mean.
He knows what he did.
To be fair, Christmas is gonna be drowning in it when he goes to the prom with his suit. Drowning in it.
Yeah, drowning his tears for being rejected by Beatrix.
Right? He's gonna be fucking heartbroken, Beatrix. Look what you did!
Yeah. Anyway, back to the cucking.
Yes.
And now back Christmas, to the
cuck. Are you aware you're about to be cucked?
Who's gonna cuck?
You.
Christmas. What?!
Beatrix is ditching you for the druid.
What the fuck?! Unfucking-believable!
I mean, like I said, okay. You're gonna be drowning in it anyways with that suit of yours, so
oh my fucking
you're the
God.
Winner in the end.
So wait, what sure. actually happened? Because I straight
Nothing
up
Nothing yet. Nothing.
Yeah, Beatrix is just gonna find Jalfa and ask her to if she's going with anyone.
Unfucking believable. This bitch. The audacity of this bitch.
Yeah. She is... God, I don't want her to be by the lakeside. Everybody's at the fucking lakeside in the school. She is
the best place to be.
Yeah, no, everybody loves the lake.
Yeah, no, Lyra needs a first, like a fucking.
Yeah, she needs to.
First hand look
to,
at the cucking.
She needs to just. Like with the argument between Marcus and Gareth.
Anyways, so.
I was just lurking in the water nearby.
You find her sitting in a fairy ring that is near the outskirts of the school into one of the forest entrances. Fairy ring isn't the circle of mushrooms. That's what you call a circle of mushrooms.
True.
She's feeding birds.
Yeah, we call them this here too.
Yeah, where do you think the name came from, Sigma?
Birds.
Anyways, yeah, she's feeding boids.
Hello.
Oh, hi. The birds, rather than flying away, kind of flock behind her, and they child behind parent kind of shyness gesture.
Nice day out here.
I suppose so.
Yeah. Are you going to the Emperor's Reverie with anyone?
I wasn't really planning to.
Well, because I'm free, so I was just wondering if you wanted to...
Free!
You're not free. You've made a commitment to a friend. You're now you're betraying him.
No, she didn't. She said,
you said yes!
She said, if no one else asks us.
But you're asking her!
Irrelevant.
You fucking liar.
Clearly dodging the thing there.
Yeah, dodging the big thing.
It's kind of sickening, really.
Yeah.
What an asshole.
Hitting me,
just want your pussy wet. Fuck you.
Christmas will remember this.
You thought Aurelius was gonna go crazy.
Christmas is gonna hunger for the dance floor. Christmas is gonna Eldritch Blast the fuck out of everybody.
Anyways, continue with your words.
Yeah, so it's just, you know, if you're not going with anyone, wanna go with me?
One moment, if you don't mind. She turns down to the birds and...
I thought you were gonna say she turns into a bird and just flies away.
I still see the shadows in my room!
The birds all kind of fly into her hands and she turns around and you can just hear, like, vague little whispers. She turns back around and the birds fly back to her shoulders as she says, as long as you don't mind me, leaving a bit on the early side.
I'm a werewolf,
I don't do well with, large crowds.
Pussy.
Yeah. I don't mind.
She nods and says, I also don't have much in the way of formal wear, so just, temper your expectations.
Beatrix is just gonna look down at, like, the military uniform she's wearing. It's like, my standards are not incredibly high.
She nods and says, I'll, see you then.
Oh, did, Zona manage to ask your sister?
Oh, how did you know?
He mentioned it when we were heading out to the place where he got shot.
I thought he fell off a horse.
Shot off the horse. That's a regional idiom.
regional dialect
for falling off a horse.
Yeah. What region?
Upstate Helios.
Oh yeah, I was mixing him up with some other dipshit, I know.
Dipshit?
It's a regional dialect for idiot.
You know what, never.
You're scaring away the hoes, Beatrix.
Anyway. Yeah, no.
Yeah, that's how I get you guys to stop making stupid dialogue. Just have people repeat shit back to you like Solid Snake.
Solid Snake.
Dipshit. Psycho dipshit.
Anyway, yeah, the point, I was there when he got hurt, but before then he mentioned he was gonna ask.
Right. Well, she is more of a social type than I, so I wouldn't be surprised. She immediately gets distracted by a rabbit hopping by and cranes her head towards that way.
I'll leave you to your birds and bunnies.
Oh, I'm sorry,
I was gonna say, Vitrix will leave it to the birds and then show the bees later.
Jesus Christ.
Boo!
For Christmas, how are you feeling?
I feel like my heart just got broken in two for some reason.
It's like that bit in Fairly Odd Parents.
You can pinpoint the exact moment his heart breaks in half.
Christmas.
This is so sad.
Are you at least gonna tell him before the prom?
Nope.
Oh my god.
That's just cruel. At least give him a heads up, Trilby.
It's just gonna tell him ahead of time.
It's 3 days before prom right now, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. 3 to 2.5.
Okay.
Well, Christmas is Christmas is gonna get this news after he spent a grueling 6 hours getting someone else's dress made. So.
Yeah. We spend like breakfast, lunch, and dinner together, and you just didn't think about it, right?
Chin up, Christmas.
Well, it hasn't happened yet. Or whatever might happen hasn't happened yet.
Okay, so Lyra just says out of nowhere.
Yeah. Thanks, Lyra. I hope nothing bad happens to me.
Yeah, I don't know why. I got the sense you might need some encouraging words.
Yeah, thanks. I appreciate it. I wonder what Beatrix is doing right now. Hopefully she's getting ready for the prom. I spent a lot of money on this suit so I don't embarrass her at the prom, but
the prom that you're going to with her.
Yeah, exactly. I was setting my hopes and dreams on like this one person, to hopefully like reciprocate the respect I give her. But if she didn't, oh man, I would be devastated.
Yeah, I guess what you mean. I guess you expect, you know, your friends to respect you enough not to, like, you know, stab you in the back.
No, just get some random pussy on the side and just, like, leave me in the dust.
Well,
everything will be okay.
Beatrix is just walking over as she hears that and then just sort of freezes and just walks away. It's like, maybe I just don't say anything.
Huh. Hey, Lyra, if you had to deal with something like this, like, say, you didn't want to go to a prom with somebody, wouldn't you just, like, tell them directly?
Well, if I was in this situation, which I never would be, I would post a letter under their door and not say anything.
That...
He says, crinkling up a letter.
Oh.
Yeah, now Beatrix is gonna go over and just sit down opposite Christmas.
Hey, bud, what's up?
Hey, so... about the prom...
Yeah?
I'm going with someone else,
Go on. Oh!
Yeah, sorry.
Oh! Okay. Bit short notice.
Yeah.
3 days before prom. So. Huh. Well.
No hard feelings, right, though.
Fuck.
Christmas roll D4. You take 2 psychic damage.
Okay. That's cool. I think I'm just gonna have to go stag then.
Lyra's cringing so hard.
He's gonna take the stag to prom? Wow, Christmas is gonna be torn apart.
Her face is sinking into her skull. That's how Lyra's cringing.
Alright, well, I just wasted a lot of money on a suit. My only suit.
Not a waste, as long as you feel good in it, you know?
Mm-hmm. I'm sure there's someone at the school my who suit. You could ask.
Nope! Everybody else is in a relationship!
What about,
Forest nurse.
Okay, Lyra, we're gonna have to have a talk about the forest nurse. Like, soon. Like, almost, like, now-ish.
Sure. Tell me about the forest nurse, Christmas.
Later.
You said
I don't want to like. No, like not now, but like later now.
I mean, Larry, are you going out with anyone?
I'm going with Gaius. Like his friend.
Oh, right. That makes
That's
more sense.
That's the second time we've used this reaction.
It's such
second time that reaction image has been posted in reference to this campaign.
Yeah.
For some reason, I get the feeling I'm not his type.
Yeah, no. That did kind of take me surprise.
Yeah, well, no one else is going to go with me, so.
Somewhere Aurelius just clutches his chest, like, oh!
Oh, there's this guy in the Optimates class, Aurelius Christmas.
Do you want
I don't know if he's going with anyone. Maybe you could ask him.
I'm not gonna ask like a random person I've never met to prom.
You might like
I'm
him.
Not gay.
He's, bro, I mean, he's gay, bro. Right. You should shoot your shot.
I don't know the guy. Why would I just like ask like, oh, I never met you before, but hey, you wanna go to prom?
He like tried to kill guys to prove his love to me, so.
What the fuck?
What?
What?
I mean, he said it was a warning shot, but like, it was awfully close for a warning shot.
And you
shot.
Want me to go to prom with him?
Well, listen. I've already like ditched him, so maybe you can assuage his broken heart.
Why would I get your sloppy seconds?
I haven't
I
had any
like
first.
I feel like the sloppy seconds no. part is not the bit that we should be focusing on. He shot
well,
guys?
Yeah, it's...
No, he shot it's... at guys, okay, and missed.
What?
Like, I'm not even sure. I think it's because Gaius was ruining his, like, perfect prom proposal or something. I'm not sure.
Who is this man?
It's who's told you, Aurelius.
That sounds like the worst guy!
Give me a minute. Kind of I'm gonna go have a chat with this guy sometime.
Yeah, no, hold on. Hey, V, I know we're not like, going to prom anymore, but, like, I'm gonna, like, I'll just blast this dude like a bunch of times.
Yeah, I'm gonna it's break fine. His fucking kneecaps.
I put a letter okay, like, on. Oh wait, are you guys defending Gaius' honor, not mine? Is this what's happening
well, like,
here?
Well, like, he kinda- he shot Gaius and not you.
Six of one, half a dozen of the other.
I was the one who was gonna get turned into fucking sushi, guys.
Well, it sounded like you were like, that all the power in the situation. You broke up with him.
I don't know if he like. I don't know if he accepts breakups. Okay, it might wake up in his fucking.
Well, he's gonna accept this breakup when I break his fucking knees.
Well,
yeah, have you told him that?
What me?
Yeah.
Yeah, I posted a letter under his door. Look, okay, he seemed like the kind of guy who might like kill me if refused directly.
Well, we're gonna kill him first. Let's talk to him. Let's
He has a gun.
I have other things.
I have a gun.
I was gonna say, if you said I have two, that would have been
a better gun than yours, Beatrix. He's like, you know, a gun guy. He's all about the guns. Your gun is just like a secondary thing.
Okay, look. If I see this guy, I'm gonna like beat the shit out of him.
Just don't interact. You know?
No, we're gonna see him around the school, so obviously we're gonna, like, meet him at some point.
I managed to not see him the whole time I've been here, so...
I think you're, like, purposely avoiding him.
I mean, I'm gonna have to see him quite regularly. He's in the dorm across the hall from me.
That's kind of unfortunate. Could you not be in the dorm across the hall from him?
No? I'm sure it'll
look,
fire.
Okay.
If I
see him, I'm gonna take him to the side and just like, you know, do some stuff.
Christmas,
I'll have a talk
like,
to him.
You like come up to his knees.
I have a bunch of magic shit. Give me some credit. Jesus Christ.
He's a walking blowjob.
No, that's Harriet.
It's true.
Give me some credit, please. Don't invalidate
like,
me. Christmas
credit is just, you know.
No, shut up!
There it is.
Christmas can turn on the intimidation. What do I have to roll for an intimidation?
Intimidation, isn't it?
Okay, I have the 3 in intimidation. I can intimidate people.
What's my intimidation?
It's probably not good.
That's alright, not amazing though. I guess
wow.
Beatrix isn't that scary.
I mean...
She's weak.
Which doesn't make much sense really, given she's a fucking massive scary werewolf lady.
It's cause it's based on charisma.
Well, I think that's silly. I think intimidation should be based on like strength or something.
I mean... You can base it on whatever skill the GM wants.
It has to be based on things that you say, so you can be intimidating looking, but you can sound like fucking Mike Tyson, or you can look really
well,
like...
Well, look,
I
Mike
mean,
Tyson
to be fair,
I mean, I'd be easily... there's no one here that wouldn't be easily intimidated by Mike Tyson.
Okay, I'm not saying, like, in person, though. Like, if you see Mike Tyson, like, in a picture or whatever, and you're like, oh, that guy looks tough, and you hear him talking, he's like, I'm gonna destroy you, I'll smack the shit out of you. It's like, oh, that's a little less bad.
Well, yeah, but he could smack the shit out of me.
Yeah, no,
I'm not gonna think I could maybe take this guy just because he sounds like that.
Anyways,
I don't have anything else to do before the promenade.
Yeah, Christmas is just gonna go by himself, I guess. Him and Starspawn.
I'm sure there's someone in the school you could ask.
Alma's going with fucking Zona. Gareth and Matilda are going together.
Unnamed NPC.
Why would
I mean,
Salt, make up an.
Just
Salt,
no, an no, 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 no. Obviously, go by yourself. Obviously, look cooler.
I know. That's what I'm saying.
Obviously,
go by myself.
Obviously, Christmas needs to continue the cycle of cucking and ask out Matilda.
Christmas is a bro. He's not gonna do that.
How about Harriet then? Cuck.
Oh wait, Christmas doesn't know Harriet and Marcus are dating, but nah.
Well, dating's Christmas... a strong word.
Okay, fucking then.
Hey, that's it.
Okay, are we good?
Yeah, Christmas is a go by himself. It's not okay.
I was gonna say we've delayed long enough. Jeez, I had an actual theme I was gonna play for this, but.
Oh my god, this is just like Harry Potter in episode 4!
The night itself finally arrives as you are all beckoned into the celebratory hall itself. It's normally reserved for things like the very start of the school year, where everybody was assembled for the, where everybody was assembled for the address by the principal, but now is obviously where the stage is set for the reverie itself. People are celebrating across the campus, but this is like the main centerpiece of the entire of the place.
I didn't get to do my thing.
Oh, well.
Oh, your thing.
My thing. Specifically, it happens like right. Okay, well, I don't know if you're leading into it or not, but.
I was gonna say that you guys will be arriving, so.
Okay.
You can still fit in.
Okay.
I'm just setting the stage. The reverie is going on throughout the entirety of the campus, pretty much, but the main event is the prom itself in this main address hall. There is these wonderful glittering decorations, these crystalline chandeliers that have been set up specifically for this event, that as the light hits them from the growing moonlight, starts to shine in different ways across the floor where students are congregating. There is a lovely centerpiece ice statue of a phoenix within the center of the hall, meant to commemorate the current emperor and his epithet as the phoenix. And some of the teachers, a few local figures, but mostly this is school-based only. Some people, such as Claudius, have declined to attend, but they obviously wish their best to everybody celebrating. With that in mind, everybody, please give me your introductions for your arrival.
Right. So, the impacts are lessened a little bit because Lyra and Gaia share a dorm. but he, they meet up, he leads her downstairs. So, his prom outfit is like a toga, as he sort of usually wears, but this one's a bit nicer, a bit like more, like it's looser than the one he would wear, you know, on mission and such. Bit longer, a bit more billowy, pure white with like a sort of yellowish, goldish trim, and only a single patch on the chest. He lead Lyra downstairs, and as they like sort of get out the doors of the dorm, he'd like pull the thread of the patch on his chest and manifest a chariot.
My god.
Wow. Jesus Christ.
Jesus You really want to bone the fish tonight.
Very embarrassing me here, guys. I didn't bring you a chariot or anything.
That's fine. You look nice, by the way.
Thank you. I went to Christmas's fabric shop.
Christmas has a fabric shop?
Yeah, he also got cucked.
Wait, what?
Beatrix ditched him for the druid bitch.
Wait, Christmas was gonna go with Beatrix?
Like, as friends, but I think Beatrix
Huh. Fuck, that sucks.
It does. We should, like...
Do you know if he's still going?
I think he's going stag.
He's going with the stag? No, I kid.
I think, he can hang with us.
Yeah, no, for sure. I was literally about to say I'll try and find him when we get there.
So, how does a promenade work, exactly? You just walk around?
Yeah, how does the promenade work? So?
I mean, it's basically just a general celebration. Like, there's food, there's music, there's a dance floor. It's basically like a day off, pretty much, for everybody to celebrate the Empire thus far.
Okay.
Obviously, don't go wild and start smashing chairs over people and shit, but, you know.
Well, look, Aurelius is...
The night is young.
No promises. Yeah.
Yeah, promises, promises.
Yeah.
But yeah, guys, would chariot the two over to the hall. Yeah.
And everyone else?
Everybody else can go ahead. I'm looking at music.
Sure. Is it gonna be the Bee Gees?
I'm trying to look for something like dignified, almost.
I mean, I guess Harriet will kind of just like show up to the main kind of area, or like the main entrance, and wait for Marcus.
Yep. You wait there for not a very long time at all, as you can hear the gentle trotting of hooves as a Margus gets off of another horse, not the one that died, not the one that died horribly in the forest. this is a new one, as he reins it in and kind of puts it to one of the posts outside. He's definitely in a more drab affair for dress compared to some of the other guys who have went more all out on their looks with this more of a plain black suit. It's got these kind of dark crimson red cuffs on it, and you can see there's a pinned brooch on one side, and on the other he has his corsage, which he very quickly kind of shifts off to make it easier to take off for you, as he says, well, sorry, I hope I didn't keep you waiting.
How come you didn't bring me a corsage, Gaius?
What's a corsage?
I don't know, I think it's like a flower thing they bring.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Okay. Yeah, sorry, that's an American prom thing. It's a flower traditionally given from the one of the dates to the other.
There you go. Well, Harriet accepts the corsage.
Ooh, flowers! She just starts eating them.
Delicious.
Nom nom nom.
You look great, by the way.
Thanks. I kind of left it to the last minute, so I just went with the first thing I saw when I made it to a textile shop.
Don't worry, I did the same.
He looks over to Gaius and Lyra and gives kind of a, not curt, but definitely a, deflated wave.
Deflated?
Wow.
No, he's not jealous. He's nervous being around you guys.
Oh.
Gaius will give him back a, like, wholehearted wave.
Lyra waves too, and then just keep muttering under her breath about the lack of flowers.
Look, you got a chariot ride. What more do you want, woman?
Alright, okay, I'm sorry. The chariot's very nice. Could have covered it in flowers, though.
Do you know how hard it is to get horses into a little patch? It's hard, okay?
Enter the Beatrix. What are you doing?
So the Almanor's sister are Optimates too, right?
Yes.
So, I guess they'd be able to...
I have this on my notes. Nope, Popularis.
Yeah, Beatrix was like, just come down in basically like a sort of short tunic with a blue sash coming down one side, belt tying it in place, with it sort of flowing down around her legs. Silver jewelry on the forearms and calves.
Alright, fucking show off.
I mean, Christmas is a show off.
No, keep going, this sounds cool.
And also, like, all the tattoos across her body, like down her arms and legs, would be visible. And yeah, she'd also have her hair all tied up, more so than usual.
When the dorm door opens, it's just Jelva in there. Alma has left much earlier in the night as she steps out, and true to what she said earlier, this is a very plain, singular colored dress of pretty much the cheapest fabric you can imagine. You figure this is probably something not meant to be formal wear, but it passes off well enough that it works for her in this instance. It is complemented by her at least kind of styling her hair slightly to part it to the side in the slight dread style that she has normally. Like I said, I'll be there for a little bit. But thank you for asking me.
Don't worry about it.
And with that, she offers out her hand.
Just Beatrix high five.
Yeah.
Too slow. Too slow.
She's gonna fist bump her.
Okay, Christmas.
So, you make your way and join the others after 20 odd minutes, leaving only one member of your merry band not presently with you.
I should also note that Beatrix has got, like, a knife on her belt.
Why?
Shit, okay.
Just in case.
That's some interesting formal wear you have there, Beatrix.
It's in like an ornate scabbard. It's a very fancy knife. But it's also a real ass knife.
Yeah, Beatrix, why'd you bring a knife?
Just in case.
Oh, in case Christmas decides to do like a school shooter thing.
Yeah, him and Aurelius are gonna team up. Friendship ended with the Helios heels. Now Aurelius is my new friend.
They're just insult buds now.
They're cuck buddies.
We good? We good, Salt?
You and me, we're not so different, Christmas.
One, two, three.
So Christmas is like pimped out right now. He has less of his bandages. He replaced them with more flowers. So like he's kind of like instead of he put like flowers over his bandages, and he's using Major Image to create some lights around him to bring out his like natural beauty, like the asceticism Maximilian was talking about. He also transmogrified a stick to look like a pimp cane.
Jesus Christ.
And, it, at the very top of the cane, it looks like Starspawn's head, just as a detail. So he's kind of just, like, swaggering into the party.
Why not do, like, a little snow globe?
Okay, like it's snow globe. Yeah, it's like snow globe with, Starspawn's head in the middle.
Yeah, as you all observe Christmas's approach, there is one singular thought on all of your minds that you cannot avoid. Somehow he was hiding all of this drip beneath those bandages.
Hey, guys!
Before he even, like, gets all the way up to them, Gaius is just gonna, like, give a thumbs up and yell out, "Looking good, Christmas."
Thanks, man! He kind of raises the cane and, like, makes a nod to him.
Well, he seems to be taking it in stride.
Yeah.
Why does he have, like, ammo belts underneath that?
Christmas basically looks like the end of Midsommar. Is that a fucking gun? Christmas comes up to the party like, "Hey! Oh man, this is a great party, isn't it?"
Yeah, it's pretty good.
I mean, I haven't really gone into the party yet.
So, like,
we're not kidding about spending a lot of money on that outfit.
A lot of money, Beatrix. I decided just to live it up, I guess. What's the etiquette at a... Like, what's the etiquette at a party? I've never been to any fancy sort of thing.
Drink as much as you can.
Yeah, yes.
Alright, cool.
Especially a formal one.
Yeah, drink as much as you can, and just, you know, cut loose, you know?
Cut a rug. Cool. Get a length of rug, cut it perfectly in half, and then you're good.
I'm gonna keep an eye out for a relapse.
Gaius is also doing that.
Oh, yeah, unbeknown
that Beatrix is also doing the same.
Yeah, Chris is gonna keep an eye out of him, while also cutting a rug. He's gonna, like, diddy bop and, like, scare daggers at Aurelius from across the room.
What's the rug thing in reference to?
Cutting a rug.
Have you never heard that phrase?
No.
Are you fucking serious?
Because you, like, move your feet across it, you're cutting the rug.
I don't.
It's dancing.
Really?
It means
you've
dancing.
Never heard that.
I've heard cutting shades.
No, cutting shades is a dance.
Is
I've
it?
I've never heard of cutting a rug.
Yeah, I haven't heard of cutting rug.
Really?
Okay, I don't know what to tell you. It is a turn of phrase.
That is interesting, because I've heard of it.
Yeah.
Huh. Oh, maybe I have heard it, and it just, like...
Okay, wait. This is the song that plays in that scene in Spider-Man
yes.
3.
Yes,
You're just now getting that?
I instantly.
I just remembered that exact riff that sounds like the Spider-Man theme.
Yeah, that's exactly why I picked it. That's why I told Knife, like, "Oh, just give me an idea."
Hang on.
Christmas is gonna hold someone's face against a train.
I said you get the money when get the money!
Christmas is gonna put some dirt in someone's eye.
Yeah. Oh my god.
Sorry, but I missed the part where that's my problem.
Wait, is this when he turns into, like, dog?
When he gets, like, the swagger walk.
The stupidest scene in the movie.
Exactly. Cool guy Peter. Damn it!
Well, the bit.
Literally! Big is more mine!
Neck does that.
Well, it's different scenes, but you know.
Yeah. So, you guys are going in the assembly hall?
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Darkspawn's here too! Everybody's here.
He's in it. Christmas has the beast ball with him, just in case.
Yeah, Christmas stuffed the beast ball down the front of his jocks.
Yeah.
Just for that added effect.
That's assuming he's wearing jocks.
So
he is going commando. No, I'm kidding.
In the hall proper, you can see the things described before: the crystal chandeliers, the large ice sculpture that is being kept permanently frozen by a little series of crystals around it to manage temperature for it. You can see a few guards standing around, mostly for formality purposes. It's, you know, at the very least, there needs to be some measure of security, even though this is basically a national holiday. You all arrive in just in time to see the principal make his way to the front of the hall and very gently tap at the podium to begin his short customary speech to commemorate the night. He clears his throat and says, "Faculty, students, esteemed, wonderful citizens of our great nation, I bid you another warm welcome to this year's Emperor's Reverie. As you all are well aware, we are celebrating the coronation of the very first emperor of this great nation, and it fills my heart with a pride that never is matched by any other day of the year than today, as I get to see out across this sea of students, see faces from all the myriad corners of this empire, and I know the wonder that we do here to ensure and prolong the future of this very sacred, holy place. It was not that long ago, in the grand scheme of time, that this empire came to the very brink of destruction, as two brothers, once with the closest of bonds, unfortunately began to conspire and work against one another, nearly tearing this very nation in half. It is only with their simultaneous death at one another's hands that their legati sat and realized the folly of division. That is why.
I was going to lean over to guys and just be like, "Is this a true story?"
Yes.
Wait, are you not paying attention in history class?
She's just going to give him a look.
Yeah, stupid question.
Dissension born of difference may sound as though it is the right of nature, of the way for beings to differentiate themselves. But the truth of the matter is that with unity, it is how we create prosperity amongst one another. With hands joined with one another, we can forge an everlasting empire that spans from sea to shining sea, horizon to horizon, on this wonderful
Beatrix's
planet.
Beatrix's hand is just sort of subconsciously tapping on the pommel of her knife
but
as he's saying this.
Tonight is not a night for speeches. It is time for celebration and to reap the rewards of cooperation, brotherhood, and most of all, our long-standing unity. May you all have long, prosperous lives, and may the Empire stand forevermore. Pax Apollos. As all the others around you briefly tap their fists to their chest with Pax Apollos in kind of a in unison.
Palutena.
So is this the bit where the stag bursts in and attacks us?
No, this is the time where you guys describe what you're doing in the party.
So the bit where the stag shows up is later. Okay, gotcha.
Okay, free.
Sometimes the stag just doesn't show up, you know?
The only stag here is Christmas.
Hey, I'm gonna kill myself after this.
Can you stop trying to play 4D chess with a board that isn't there and roleplay?
Well, I don't want
to. So, you can go first. I'll go a little later into the night. Oh, you don't want to go first.
I don't want to go first. That's what I was saying. God.
Jesus Beatrix, Christ. Okay,
Beatrix
so
is going to perform some sort of a dance that she knows.
She's doing the fucking Commander Shepard shuffle.
she's doing fucking Gunblade Reload animations while squatting.
Give me a performance.
I actually
realized that all I need is fucking Misty Step and I can just do all four Dante styles.
You know, the thing that matters the most is that you are you're having fun with it. At least I hope you're having fun with it, because it's a terrible performance otherwise, and therefore it's useless if you're not at least having fun with it. But you're having fun with it.
So you all are watching
Beatrix make a rare ass out of herself.
Oh god, that's terrible.
You know, I wish we did
save this
stuff to save and record images. That'd be great.
If only we knew someone who had a camera.
Where is?
Assuming that Gaius, Christmas, and Lyra are all hanging out, Gaius is just gonna watch the events unfolding on the dance floor and just turn to the other two and just say, "Savor this moment, Gaius. This is a rare thing."
Lyra is. I don't know. What's the drink limit from the bar?
Well, they're not serving alcoholic drinks.
Alcohol?
No. Not every student hears of drinking age.
Well, fine. Lyra's gonna take out her hip flask and start putting booze in the non-alcoholic drink she got from the bar.
She's just like kind of like a tiny little drop of juice or whatever in it, and then just like fills it up with vodka.
She's a party girl. She knows how these things go.
Lyra, I'm gonna have to confiscate that off you, and Geist is gonna take the hip flask and spike his own drink before giving it back.
Bitch, I was about to fucking suggest you go and take your clothes off and hump a wall or something.
Fucking hell.
That's excessive.
Christmas, Jordan. I'm joking. Christmas, Jordan.
No. Hey, do you know anything about the band that's playing? They're just like playing really slow.
Yeah, it's more orchestral slow dance music.
Christmas is gonna like sidle up to the conductor. The orchestra. Yeah, conductor. It's like, hey, could you kind of speed this up a little bit? Play something you can actually like dance to.
This is dance music.
Well, like, maybe a different kind of dance, you know?
Christmas is gonna pull a fucking Marty McFly back to the future.
This is the session in which Christmas learns that orchestras practice for months, and also the conductor basically does nothing because they all know their timing.
Like, it's performance. Anyways, the conductor is going to look over to the orchestra. Some of them have kind of, they're looking over and slightly slowing their play to understand what's going on. He sighs and kind of flips through the pages of notes and other songs that he has in the list. He looks over and points the little conductor. Baton. Yeah, baton. Points the baton at a page of music that... Do you know music?
Christmas? Yeah.
Yeah. This one is definitely much more up-tempo.
Yeah, he can play and read music. He has that performance. Yeah. Christmas plays play with hippies. He knows how to, like, get down.
He taps on his little conductor podium to cut the song short and switch over to the next one.
There it is! I didn't even...
I thought this was going to go into Fly Away for a second. I got really excited.
No, so then there'd be angels covered in nuts.
Nuts.
Christmas is gonna like get in the middle of the floor and try to like start his own dance, like the Rick dance in Rick and Morty. He's just gonna like get in the middle of everybody and just like bust the fuck out like sick nasty dance moves.
Marcus is going to look over after the music changes and finally, he does kind of start to ease up, seeing Christmas do what he's doing on the floor, as he offers a hand over to you, Harriet, and says, well, care to join me?
I'd be honored.
How tall is Marcus again?
Like six-something, right?
Yeah, he's six-something.
Yes.
I mean, the bull's like 7 foot, so...
Yeah, so... Oh,
go on.
I was just gonna work.
Harriet's like... Oh, hey.
Just like step on his like shoes and just dance like that, I guess.
Like
I don't know.
Holding you up by the way.
Wait,
it's less of a traditional prom partner dance with it, as more of a okay, for the record, I have no idea how to do partner dances in real life, so forgive my descriptions for being possibly lacking.
Yeah, also seeing both Christmas and Marcus take to the dance floor, Geist is gonna offer a hand to Lyra.
Well, I guess
get off.
Yeah, we can't let these jokers show us up.
I was gonna say we can't leave Christmas by himself out there, but okay.
That's it.
Let's go. She's gonna like down the rest of her hip flask and sail out onto the floor.
Yeah. It's much less of a partner dance, more in dancing next to each other with an attempt at keeping them easy for the sake of synchronicity. But it does seem that Marcus is actually slightly better at this than you would expect him to be. I'll have everybody roll performance.
Please, God, don't fuck me today. 17.
Oh no. That drink hit a lot harder than you guys thought it did.
Alright. So, basically, the way this goes down, Beatrix, you start to kind of get your groove, at least once you're in a group with everybody else. All of you kind of are starting to turn heads as you change the music and quite literally start to essentially change your conversation with the dance you're going into. Harriet, you and Marcus basically have this like one-to-one sync with one another as he's doing like pass-by power slides next to you, and you're like doing the same to mirror him going the other. What? Yeah, going on the knees.
It's not very Roman.
Neither is playing Shine from Ruby. It's called. Yeah, they didn't have school proms back then either. It's okay. Anachronistic. Anyways.
Hey.
It kind of culminates in this very elaborate, almost ice skater style bit with him kind of picking you up. Surprising, given, like, even though you're a halfling, it's still, like, a considerable weight to pick up a person, as he kind of does a slight spin, holding the dress down, so you're not flashing anybody, but,
give us a flash, Harriet.
Before finally, spinning and then ending in a dip, with you going downwards towards the floor before he kind of realizes you're almost about to go, and then he rights you back to your feet. Gaius, you, despite being the nimblest of everybody in combat when it comes to a much less performance. Yeah, a much less guided thing like a dance, it kind of makes you realize that when you're not having to react to fight or flight instincts and whatnot, you kind of seem to falter, especially in comparison to what Marcus and Harriet are doing, like directly across from you. You manage a little bit of a Commander Shepard shuffle sort of thing, but luckily for you, your date's not doing much better, is she?
I was doing some dance from her village.
It seems either the podunk town village raising or the drunkenness has gotten to already, and she's an extreme lightweight, as she has what look like her attempts at dance moves, but like, you know, putting through a drunk filter of two or three drinks.
Yeah, it's mostly swaying.
And Christmas, you kind of rising from the ashes with Phoenix as your backdrop, you have managed to cast off the despair of being rejected before and made yourself into a singular, wonderful, eye-catching, head-turning being as you do all these elaborate things where you're doing cross splits and not destroying your crotch. You're tossing
the cane up in the air, catching it with the offhand.
You know the very end of the disco minigame in Yakuza with the slide and then the finger point outwards?
Yeah.
That's basically your big flourish, but then...
I cannot do that game at all. It's fucking impossible.
But as soon as it goes, the cane lands and you just catch it above your head as everybody just goes up in a cheer.
Woo! Go Christmas!
And that's where the session ends. Okay, everybody. Thanks for coming out.
The stag hasn't smashed in the doors yet.
I'm joking.
Aurelius hasn't smashed in the doors yet.
Christmas, as you are kind of relaxing briefly, like breathing heavily from your little bit of exertion, you notice the large doors that lead into the assembly hall open slightly, as a group of three guards kind of walk in. Their helmets are kind of shadowed over their faces briefly, which strikes you as a little odd as they walk over to one of the other guards. You can hear the brief snippets of conversation between both of them.
Would I be able to make it out?
Sorry, I have to grab something.
Oh boy.
Yeah,
I've got a 16 passive perception, so... And also, Beatrix is absolutely on edge because she thinks something is going to happen.
Yeah, you're metagaming, I know.
It's not metagaming.
It's not metagaming.
Wow, I can't believe that the person with PTSD has hypervigilant behavior.
Yeah.
What have you got PTSD from?
I don't know, maybe the massacre of her hometown?
Christmas, as you see this go down, the guard kind of raises a question as he looks over to one of the guards. Beatrix, you can straight up hear what he's saying, as he says, Cedric, you don't look so good. As he says that, he is completely interrupted by the guard rearing his head back with an ugly snap, and he just dives for his neck and bites in.
Oh! Jesus. Okay!
Is this part of the entertainment?
Everybody who sees this kind of runs back screaming from it, as you can see the doors just straight up burst open at this point, and a gaggle of guards and a few miscellaneous adults come in, just shambling with you can see bits of wood just bursting out of their chests in, like, haphazard patterns, and you can see a sickly green glow about their eyes, as in front of all of them is a figure with the body of a person, but the severed head of a horse, kind of haphazardly sewn on with little bits of vine.
Jeremiah!
As it comes forward, and very heavily breathing, as everything seems to come to a standstill, it looks over the crowd and begins to speak, as it says,
Where is the shepherd?
From within the crowd, Gaius yells out Sol Invictus as the astral arms manifest, and he starts pushing his way through.
Hey Gaius, what's going on?
I'm gonna hand Harriet my knife that I brought with me.
Harriet kindly accepts and makes her way to the shambling hall.
As you get closer and people are, like, tripping over each other running, you can hear glass shattering, chairs being turned over as people are starting to run towards the back. You can hear a few of your other classmates who are starting to, like, join in with the confusion as the horse-headed leader to the figures is going to mumble something as the zombified crowd starts to chant.
Never to dream, never to die, never to wake.
As
you came here intending never to die, you made the wrong move, my friend.
As they make their way towards you.
Sort of familiar.
And with that, we will cut session.
Cool.
Oh, no.